half of this poem thinking it would be the only half of this poem about 2 weeks ago as I was ending my maternity leave and about to go back to work. And then last night, after having completed my first full week back at work, decided that the poem was not done and added to it. And yeah, so it's going to be a little unpolished near the second half. But I'm much more pleased with where it went. There's a lot of Harry Potter reference.
Woo!
Yeah! I thought this would be an appropriate space. Yeah, so all you really need to know, if you're not a Harry Potter person, you'll still get it. All you really need to know is I grew up with these characters. I was always the same age as them. And the most glorious thing in the world happened that 2 weeks after I gave birth and became a parent, J.K. Rowling, the author, released part 8 of Harry Potter, which is a play about all of the characters that I grew up with now becoming parents themselves. And it was like the most healing, reflective thing I'd experienced ever. Yeah. So this poem is about my reflection into thinking about who I have always been in my life pre-baby, who I had to become because of birth, through birth. And I guess remembering who I can continue to be after baby, because for a while there I really lost my sense of self, my identities outside of being a mom. And I'm reconnecting with that skin. So, oh, it says you got this. That's sweet. That's really sweet. Oh, and also there, it feels inauthentic for me to perform this without some kind of movement, so It's just gonna be a little bit of that.
Yeah, girl.
I tried and it was wrong. It was wrong with that. So, okay. This is called Hands Raised. Very nervous. Before I knew her name, and for as long as I can remember, I have been Hermione Granger. I know what it is to be starved for a book, craving for a puzzle. Blood boiling in righteous anger, furious at injustice. Getting my smug fix from hands raised too fast. Hands raised for good grades, and then for attention. Hand raised for confirmation, then in confirmation. Hands raised on blackboards, weighed down by books. Treasuring, loving. Hands raised in presentation, in song, in dance. Hands raised with something to say. Hands raised in outrage. I trusted you, you foul, loathsome, evil little cockroach. Hands raised when no one else will. I can't believe no one did anything about this before now. Hands raised in protest. S-P-E-W. Resist! Resist! Hands raised in persistence. In solidarity. Leadership. Hands raised in protection, and in fear, in battle, in birth, hands raised in joy, too quickly drowning in depression, loneliness, grief. Hermione wasn't ready to give birth. When I last saw her, she was ill-prepared. She wasn't patient, she wasn't gracious, an insufferable know-it-all, really. Simply put, she wasn't Lily. Hand raises in realization. How blind have I been? I would be proud to raise my hand as Lily. To be remembered for the undying love I gave my child, to be seen in the eyes of Harry. He looks just like his father. He has his mother's eyes. I had to become Lily. The lightning-shaped scars on my body bear witness to the sacrifice required, killed by birthing pains that must not be named. So shameful, so silent, so small. I raise my hand to break through that barrier, to shatter that glass ceiling. I step into the light, embodiment of fierce grace, bursting forth a spell so powerful, hate and fear are banished. Dementors for another day, my Patronus dancing in the laughter of my child. Lily never had a post-baby. That story ended. It's time for that chapter of sacrifice and suffering to end. There's so much life left to be celebrated. Hands raised as I gently close the book of Lily, treasuring, loving, and having learned so much. I set her on my nightstand to be referred to often. Hands now raised in acceptance. Hands now raised for help up. In remembrance of my strength, in remembrance of my sensuality, in remembrance of my sense of self. And the veil lifts away. Distant voices now speak clear, new pages to be my mirror and teacher. Seeing myself, I became better. Hands still raised in protest, but the outrage has been soothed. Hands still raised in battle, but the wounds have been healed. My hand is still on that blackboard, still bearing books and minds and souls. My backbone has grown stronger from baby carry bouncing and booby-eating monsters on my back. My hand is raised for overflowing diapers, booger-sucking filled days, and teething fever-filled nights. My hand is raised for a bibbidi-boppidi-boop, a my hands are raised, and are you not entertained? Floating atop the gurgling giggles and resting upon love me little eyes, my eyes. My hand is raised to wipe the exhaustion from my smiling face. Holy fuck, this is hard. In commiserating high fives and the peaceful bliss following a tantrum, good job, sweetie, that one was rough. My hand raised in tender touches at midnight shift changing hours.
Tag, babe, you're it.
My hand is raised in thankful hugs after daddy duty overtime. Thanks, sweetie, you saved me on that one. My hands are raised in the embrace of my angel, my Harry, safe and in my arms. The ending that Lily never got is mine. Hands raised in a solemn bow of gratitude to the creator of this wizarding world, this gift of knowing myself. Knowing my educator, my activist, my leader, and now my mother, for as long as I can remember, before I knew her name. I am Hermione Granger, and my hand is raised. Yay!